Hello, I'm David and you're watching Cruise Show UK. Today we're on board Virgin Voyages Scarlet Lady and we're going to show you around with a full ship tour. We'll start our tour on Deck 5 at the Redemption Spa. It's complete with hydrotherapy pool, mud room, salt room, cold plunge pools, quartz beds and rejuvenating spa treatments. Next door is Sailor Services. If you need any assistance from the fantastic crew, this is the place to come. Further aft is Pink Agave, a complimentary specialty Mexican restaurant designed by Tom Dixon. Pink Agave offers a wide variety of authentic Mexican specialities. Razzle Dazzle is a fabulous restaurant named for the camouflaging pattern painted on warships from World War I and World War II. Razzle Dazzle was designed by Concrete Amsterdam and offers vibrant and creative twists on a largely vegetarian contemporary American fare. Up to Deck 6 and The Wake. It's my favourite restaurant on board. It offers a sophisticated take on steak and seafood. Wake is designed by Roman and Williams and we thoroughly enjoyed our food here with some fantastic views out to sea. Moving forward is Extra Virgin, the ship's Italian trattoria, serving regionally inspired Italian culinary traditions. The space features communal tables and a private dining room. On the other side is the Test Kitchen. This laboratory-style eatery, designed by Concrete Amsterdam, is part cooking school and part restaurant. Spanning both sides of the centre of the ship is the High Street, a comprehensive shopping complex, and it's one of the best I've seen at sea. Further forward is the very sociable bar called On the Rocks. Opposite the bar is a well-being area featuring stubble and groom, an upscale barber shop, an oasis for men who enjoy being pampered and well-groomed. The dry dock is a hair and nail salon with beauty bar. Then there's Squid Ink, the first ever tattoo studio on board a cruise ship. Moving forward, there's a full casino with gaming machines and tables such as roulette and blackjack. On the other side of the ship, spanning two floors, is The Manor, an alluring nightclub and a fantastic place to get an Instagram-worthy photo. Inspired by Richard Branson's history in the music industry and his first ever Virgin Music Studio of the same name. The Den is a small event space for private get-togethers. Moving up to Deck 7, spanning two floors, is the Red Room. It's not your typical onboard theatre for sure. We watched a show called Dual Reality and it was simply heart-stopping. literally not to be missed. Moving aft, there is a set of private karaoke rooms called the Groupie. On the other side of the ship is SIP, the onboard champagne bar. They also serve pastries and coffee here during the day, and it's really, really popular. The central part of the ship is called the roundabout, and it really is the heart of the ship. There's always something happening here in this lovely space, and it was a great place to people watch and just hang out. Get Lost is the place to go to book another voyage. They had a brilliant offer on, which was too good to miss. We've booked on the Valiant Lady for March 22 and the Scarlet Lady again in September 22. Can't wait. Lick Me Till I Scream is the onboard complimentary ice cream bar. The ice cream and the waffle cones here are outstanding. We absolutely love the pizza place, where you can grab a quick bite to eat. You can follow your pizza and build it to your liking, from the dough, the sauce, cheese, and of course all the toppings. On the other side of the ship is the Grounds Club, the onboard coffee bar with sustainably sourced coffee beans. The drinks here are at an additional cost. Further aft is the social club featuring the arcade and other games. It was a really fun place to hang out. The Loose Cannon is a local dive bar offering some exciting drinks and cocktails. Moving further aft, there is the Dock, which features an indoor and outdoor eatery. The Dock is a rustic beach club inspired space. Decks 8 to 14 feature just cabins, so let's move up to deck 15. At the aft of the ship is the galley. This really is unlike any buffet that you'll find on other cruise ships. There's a dedicated bakery and pastry shop, a panini shop, a burger grill, taco shack, sushi bar with bento boxes, a noodle bar, a soup and salad stand, and a 24-hour American diner. We came here for breakfast each morning, and it was a great place to sit and relax and look at all the sea views. The service was impeccable as well, the staff were fantastic. Next, there is the Korean barbecue, Geumbae, a social, hands-on, interactive, fun dining experience. Geumbae features specially engineered flameless grills built into each table, and it's really, really fun. Forward is B Complex, the ultimate well-being and fitness experience with strength, spin, yoga and cardio in its build, burn, bike and balance rooms, all with dramatic ocean views. The fitness options on board the Scarlet Lady are probably the best I've seen at sea. Further forward is the well-being pool, designed by Concrete Amsterdam as an area of restoration featuring a large whirlpool and two plunge pools. There's also the nearby gym and tonic bar. The main pool is called the Aquatic Club, a space on board where you can lounge poolside and soak up the sun with your favourite drink or cocktail. Moving up to deck 16 is Richard's Rooftop, a members-only outdoor space for stargazing parties and pre-dinner cocktail hours. This place is for rock stars and the mega rock stars. Further aft is the Sun Club, plenty of space to relax and take in the sun. There's plenty of games in the training camp, which is a super fun adult play area. There's also a basketball court in this area. At the aft of the ship is the net, a big catamaran net suspended in the middle of the ship, offering outstanding views to those that dare. Finally, up on deck 17, you'll find the runway. Designed by Concrete Amsterdam, this standalone running track forms a halo-like vision over the ship. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. It really helps me out. Take a look at all these cruises I've booked so I can bring you lots more content each month. Please comment and let me know what you think about the Scarlet Lady. Until next time, I'll see you up on deck.